Level design is a lot about coming up with the puzzles and the layout and the pacing of an area and coming up with the themes and how they integrate with the story. I worked with Corey to kind of pace it out on paper in a very, very rough form. Corey figured out what he wanted in the script, and then we agreed upon different worlds and kind of the scale of the worlds, what mechanics we wanted to introduce in those worlds, and then set up the layout to facilitate that. On a day-to-day basis, working with all the different level designers to make sure that everything kind of had a consistent feel to it.
And then when you jump on it, it's just like a straight elevator ride down.
Level design is about planning and like figuring out like, okay, if we want this, then like how are we gonna stage this, and kind of sticking to your guns, but at the same time, having the fluidity to kind of like change gears when you need to, just be like, oh, well, if that totally doesn't work, throw it away, you know, and like, you know, start all over again.
Basically, you have to look at the game from the top down. So we have to say, well, we just had a puzzle here, so let's try to like have a big fight, because it's a little bit more visceral after you just used your brain to, you know, figure out this crazy puzzle that we threw in. So we do that kind of stuff, like the just how we want the fights to go, difficulty level of the fight. How we determine how to pace the fights is very much trial and error. We'll spend days on a fight, and then we'll have a play test, and then we can throw all of what we just did out the window. You can tell just by watching them play.
Camera design is basically taking the player and guiding them through the interactive experience. So the camera designer's job is to help the player understand a puzzle, where to go, what he needs to see in order to achieve success in a video game.
Camera in a game like God of War 2 is incredibly important because it basically shows the player everything that he needs to know in order to become a master at the game.
When we're doing like play tests and stuff like that, we're trying to figure out what are these players trying to see.
We're trying to make sure that we're thinking about, well, what is the player's experience at any point, and what is the player thinking about, and so we show that.
The basic viewpoint is that we're trying to stay behind Kratos and we're trying to lead the player in the proper direction. We change it up when you get into an arena and you do some combat and stuff like that. Generally, you don't necessarily need to be behind Kratos at that point of view. You want to see all the enemies and stuff around you. So we might go to a side view, we might go to a three-quarter top-down view. We go to different views in order to provide perspective for the player so that he can see the enemies around him a little bit better. He can have combat a little bit better. His controls feel right for the combat. But that wouldn't necessarily be the same view that we have for when we're you know, following them, when we're trying to just lead them from one point to another point.
We take control away from the player on the camera and we give them the shots they want and let them focus on just the gameplay itself. A limitation of our fixed camera system is that we have to show certain things at different points. So a lot of times we set up what's called a cut camera, and we, like, you walk into a room, there's a lever on the other side, and we need to let you know that that's where you need to be. So we'll zoom in on the lever, show that, and then back out and say, okay, you know, now do what you want, but we pretty much just told you where to go.
You only notice the cameras when they're bad. So I think that if you don't notice the camera work, I think maybe we're doing our job right.
I get the most satisfaction when I've completely designed a space, and a room or a wad, we call them. And I pass that off to the artists, and then the artists dump all their art in and pass it off back to me. And it's the first time I see it, and it's all fully arted, and I'm like, whoa, this is what I designed? This is what the artist did with that space? This is the sheet version of the level. This is the start point in the spire. It's just a sandbox for us to go in and figure out exactly how the design is gonna work. This is after the sheet version that I just showed you was sent off to the artists and then returned. It gets really magical when it comes back from the artists, and they've done really cool stuff with it.
I was presented with a door and a dead body, and I knew I needed to use the dead body in some way, some new and interesting way, in order to get through that door. So what I have here is the actual level that I was presented with in a wireframe, and this is the completed in-game version. Initially, the player may think that they have to put the dead body on the pressure plate and just walk over here. But since the door only opens halfway, that's not the entire puzzle. If they come over here, they'll notice there's this other pressure plate, which opens the door all the way. So if I make a run for it, kind of go through, I just don't have enough time in order to get over there. So the distance between here and the final door is much less than the distance between here and the final door. So I should probably put that dead body on that pressure plate. And I realized that this debris that's floating by in the river was the same debris that was floating by in this other river. So it must be some kind of circuit. So I put the dead body into the river just to see what would happen. And come over here and check in. And oh, there's my dead body. So pick that bad boy up, put him onto the pressure plate. That opens the gate halfway. Now I'm closer to the door, so I should be able to make a break for it and run over here and exit through the door just in time.
For me, I just kind of like first start off with just like imagining just like what would be like, you know, the coolest possible scenario that someone could go through on like a grapple sequence, given like the parameters. And then I'll start like going down on paper and like just drawing, like sketching out the rough ideas. And then from there I go into like Maya, and then I'll start actually building out the level, putting the points in, and then I'll start going in there and like tweaking it and tuning it until it's done. I was thinking like, wouldn't it be cool if something else is kind of going on in the background, something else to kind of like, as you're going through this, you're like racing against this other, basically like a fuse on a bomb or something. That's kind of like the idea I was trying to go with. And something also visually, like, so when you're going through like this, you're like, shit, that's awesome, you know? Like, this is like a really cool sequence. So am I gonna make it? Am I gonna make it? Am I gonna make it? That's kind of like the ramping up that I wanted to feel. And then like that last moment when you're flying through and then you make it and then you're like, phew, you know, I'm done. I hope in the end, you know, even if you're restarting and playing through a couple times, that it's not that long and you'll be able to get through it and you'll be able to have a, you know, an awesome experience, so.